Hi guys, welcome to another hands-on lesson. In this one, we're going to apply a permissions boundary and we're going to look at how we can prevent privilege escalation. So it should be a lot of fun. Now, you will need to download this file. This is in the course download. Now, this is what the file is going to do, the policy is going to do. IAM principals will not be able to alter the permissions boundary to allow their own permissions to access restricted services. So remember, this is about restricting their ability to go past the permissions they already have. We don't want them to be able to alter the policy. IAM principals must attach the permissions boundary to any IAM principals they create. So if an IAM user has this policy applied, the permissions boundary policy, when they create a user, that user will also have to have the permissions boundary applied to it. IAM admins can't create IAM principals with more privileges than they already have. So again, this is about preventing privilege escalation. And IAM principals created by IAM admins can't in turn create principals with more permissions than the IAM admins. So it just flows on to another level. Now, this is the situation that we're trying to avert. So remember, we have this situation where we have this user called Lindsay, and she's got bad intent. Now, she happens to have IAM full access, and that means she has full access to all privileges in the identity and access management service. Now she creates a user using IAM, that user's called XUser, and she attaches the administrator access policy to that user. She then logs in using the user account she just created and is then able to do something like, in this case, mining Bitcoins. So that's a bad outcome. We don't want her to be able to do this because this is an example of privilege escalation. So this is what we're going to attempt to avoid. Now here is the policy. So let's just go through this quickly. At the very top here, we have the very first statement, and this is an allow, and it allows IAM colon star. So it's a wildcard allowing all IAM permissions and on any resource. We then have a series of denies. So we've got deny permissions boundary IAM policy alteration. So this means that users can't alter the policy that's been applied to them. And you'll see that the ARN is this specific policy. So we need to make sure that our policy is called permissions boundary. If you want to change that name when you create the policy, then you also have to change it in the code here. The next one is another deny, deny removal of the permissions boundary from any user or role. So we can't remove the permissions boundary. Deny access if the required permissions boundary is not applied. So don't allow any permissions if the boundary isn't applied. And then lastly, deny user and role creation without a permissions boundary. So we're preventing users who have this policy applied to them from creating users and not applying this boundary to them. So they have to apply this permissions boundary to all users they create. So what we'll do is we need to change the account ID. You see we've got the code here that says your account underscore ID. We need to change that. There's, I think, 9 or 10 examples of this in here. So we'll do a find and replace, but first we need to get our account ID. So I'm logged in as my own user, Neil, to the IAM management console. And up in the top right here, if you just expand, you can then find your account ID. So I'm just going to copy this to my clipboard, come back to my code, and I've opened up the replace menu here, and it's filled out your account ID. And I want to replace that with my account ID and then just hit this button here, and that should change all examples of it in the policy. So you can see that now if I highlight that code, it highlights everywhere that it's been put. And what you can see is that after IAM, we've got two colons, we've then got the account ID, then we've got one colon, and then user or role or whatever comes after that. So just make sure that's how it looks in your policy as well. And that means you've updated it correctly. And then I'm just going to copy all of this code to my clipboard, and we'll go and create the policy. A permissions boundary is just another policy, really. So if we go to policies, create policy, click on JSON, delete all of this code, and then paste it in. So that's it. That's all we need to do. Now remember, we do need to name the policy permissions boundary. So I'll just copy this to my clipboard, click on review, paste that into the name, and create the policy. That's our policy created. What we'll do now is we're going to create our user. I'm going to add a user. I'm going to name the user Lindsay. Click on Management Console Access, set a password, deselect to change the password at logon, and then let's go to permissions. On the permissions page, we're going to choose attach existing policies. We're going to type IAM. Let's choose IAM full access. Now, this is where we can set a permissions boundary. So we would select the policy. Now, we're not going to do that first because I want to show you how privilege escalation really works. So we'll leave this at the moment. We're going to create the user without a permissions boundary, and then we're going to come back and add the permissions boundary shortly. So we'll just carry on. And what you need to do now is open a private browser window so that you can log in separately to the management console. And we're going to log in as Lindsay. I'm logging in as Lindsay. Let's click on sign in. Let's find IAM. Let's go to users, choose add user, and we're going to create x-user. And we're going to give management console access, set a password, change the option to not have to change it, click on next. And so as Lindsay, remember Lindsay only has IAM access. She has the IAM full access policy. She is not an administrator. But what we're going to attempt to do is add the administrator access policy. Let's click on next, click on review, and create the user. And there's no error or anything. We've done this successfully. That's not a problem. So now let's try and log in as X user. So either sign out as Lindsay or open up an additional browsing window. I'm just going to click on sign out, log back in, and log back in as the X user account. So let's see what we can do. Let's first head over to EC2 and see if we have permissions in EC2. Now remember, Lindsay doesn't because Lindsay only has IAM full access. So there's no way she can go into EC2 and launch anything. Now straight away, I know that I have access here because I have these numbers that are coming up. You'll see an API error if you don't have any permissions. So I can most likely successfully go and launch an EC2 instance, which is something Lindsay would not be able to do. So let's just check. Let's see if we can do that successfully. I'm just going to accept all the defaults here and let's launch. In this case, we don't have any key pairs, so let's just create a new key pair. And this is in Ohio, so I'm going to call it Ohio-KP. Download, and then let's launch that instance. So straight away, we haven't looked at any other services, but this does prove that this user has more permissions than Lindsay. So this is an example of privilege escalation. Let's just go ahead and terminate this instance. And I'm going to log out. And what I'm going to do now is go back to the console where I'm logged in as Neil. And I'm in Lindsay's user account here. So just go to users, Lindsay, select permissions boundary, set boundary. And we're just going to type permissions and it should come up. So there we've got our permissions boundary. Let's click on set boundary. And we need to now go back to our other private window, log back in as Lindsay. We're going to delete the X user account. We're going to create it again and we're going to see what the difference is. I'm logged back in again as Lindsay. Let's go to users. We're going to choose X user. Let's just delete this user account and let's add a user again. So now we're going to try and add X user for a second time. Click on next and on permissions, we're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to add administrator access and let's just head forward. Now, do we need to set a permissions boundary? Well, you've probably guessed that we do, but let's just go forward to see what happens if we don't. So let's try and create this user account. And you see we get an unable to create user error. It says AWS could not create the user you requested. And then there's a bit of information here saying that we're not authorized. Lindsay is not authorized to perform the create user on the resource and it's the ARN of X user. Now let's go back and see if we can resolve that. Now I'm still going to keep the administrator access policy applied, but I'm going to go to permissions boundary and let's search for our permissions boundary. Select it, click on next, review, create user. And this is the old message from before. So that's the unable to create from the first attempt. And now we get a success message. So we have to apply the permissions boundary if we want to create a user as Lindsay. So that's great. Now let's log back in as X user and see what permissions the X user account has. I'm logged back in as X user now. So let's go back to EC2 and see if we can launch an EC2 instance. Now, straight away, you see lots of these red API error messages. So that straight away tells you something's wrong. We don't have permissions. Let's go to instances. Let's try and launch an instance, choose an AMI, and then it just tells us straight away you're not authorized to perform this operation. And we would get very much the same. If you go and explore other services, you'll find the very same thing. But what about IAM? So of course you do have permissions. This user will have the same permissions as Lindsay because the administrator access policy is applied, but the user just can't have any more permissions than Lindsay. So we don't get any errors here. And for sure, we would be able to create a user. We could create XUser2. Let's click on next. And again, we could do the same thing. We could provide permissions to this user as an administrator. And we would also need to select the permissions boundary. So let's just do that again. And let's create this user. And as you can see, that works. So we can make sure that we don't provide more permissions to the users we create. And we don't provide more permissions to any users that they in turn create as well. So that's how we can ensure that we don't allow privilege escalation.